So I know there's been a lot of good work done along those lines, absolutely. Needs to be more work done along those lines, and somehow catalyze this. Again, the entire situation of the world hinges upon the will to do it, to actually do it, to prove to yourself. You cannot just say, well, I think I can do it. You have to prove to yourself you can do it. It's very different. So, how can we inspire others to prove to themselves that they can do it? That's the question. That's the whole thing. It's more important even than any teaching at this point, actually. The content of the teaching is secondary right now to the ability of people, the willingness to actually prove to themselves they can do it. And that will enable them to short-circuit their interest in this massive operatic drama that is slated to arrive here and roll out upon everybody. An avalanche. There's a huge avalanche slated to happen. And they'll say, no. I don't really want that. I can actually get what I really want. I can get what I really want, which is just I am, not I am this. I am something. No, I am. Just I am. Which inherently then is the realization of the formless. Okay, but the vision of oneness is what we really want, actually. The vision of oneness, of just this I am-ness. So how does that happen? That's what we need to pray for. How does that happen? How can we break the logjam of people thinking about it? And I've been trying to break it, but it hasn't happened yet. Now, we're not talking about yoga and stretching and all this. We're talking about sitting quietly and dropping all activity. Dropping all activity. All activity, dropping it. Stepping away from it. Stepping away from the cliff. Just one or two steps. 1 hour, 2 hours, maybe two steps, 2 hours, let's say. Stepping away from the cliff. 2 hours is two steps away from the cliff. Prove to yourself you can do it. Prove to yourself you can do it. Then it's a whole new ball game for you, an entirely new ball game. You can say no to the avalanche. No. Don't need that. I thought I needed it, but now I realize I don't. Because I can evaporate this continuity fear. I have the capacity within me. I know I can do it. I proved it to myself. I can do it. It's like a crippled person taking a step and realizing, hey, I can walk. Or someone who's been paralyzed and through some shock or something, some psychosomatic shock, and they finally take a first step and they say, oh my gosh, I can walk. And they take a second, they take two steps. I say, you know what? I can walk. I may not be able to run right away, but I eventually will be able to run. So I'm gonna start practicing walking right now. Forget about being paralyzed and watching some drama on television. I can walk. Let me start walking here. It's all that it takes. It's all that it takes is just to break the ice. So this is what's really going on right now. This is the big picture right now. People come away, they may not have some great insight or anything, but they actually have something bigger than that. They say, you know what, I can do it. And that gives leverage over the situation. And they say, you know what, I don't have to try and keep believing in an I. I can give up that belief. I can give up the belief that what I am can be defined. It has to be defined, or supposed to be defined, or is in a process of being defined. I say, I know this is all actual self-deception. It is a play of light upon light that I ask for, but I have a continuity fear. So you come away and say, you know, I got a continuity fear, but I have the tools to face this fear. And gradually melt it away. I have it. Makes all the difference in the world. You don't go over the cliff. And by not going over the cliff, you actually then start using the tools and start getting breakthroughs. And you say, wow, I'm not as stuck as I thought I was. Maybe I don't need so much future. Maybe I don't need so much drama. Maybe I don't, you see. And gradually, the momentum builds up like that. But without getting started, without this proof, how can you build any momentum? You cannot. Because any breakthrough you have will actually freak you out. Because you say, well, how can I put this into physicality in the future? And then you get over activated in your mind. You get frantic. All this kind of stuff, right? Now, if a teacher shows up, great teacher shows up, put them in the test. Okay, just say, hey, I don't care what your teaching is, really. Just, let's just sit for a couple hours quietly. Let's see, you know, how are you able to inspire that? That's the test, really. That is really the test. So if a teacher says, well, we need to do this, and follow me, and this, and this, and this. No. Just start out, let's just sit quietly for 2 hours. Test the quality of their silence. Test the quality of their stillness. Test the quality of their serenity. Test the quality of their inspiration. Test all of that. That's what's important. That's what's really important. The teaching is something that is only effective when the capability of sitting silent, the will, the determination, the will, the capacity to be quiet. Quiet enough so you can absorb the shock of this staggeringly great news that is emerging. The dawn. I mean, the dawn of the great news begins. And you're kind of watching the dawn of this incredible realization. And it's just, you know, staggering. So fantastically wonderful news that you just have to stay still. Can't act it out. This is not something you can act out. So the acting out has to stop. You have to prove to yourself you can stop the acting out for a couple hours. Now maybe the hardest thing you've ever done. But once you do it, you say, that wasn't so difficult. Well, why did I think it was so difficult? But what's difficult is to even try. That's the difficulty. So the icebreakers have to arrive in this world, I'm telling you. If we're really to have a real pushback on the future, if we want to really roll back the future, push back the future, the icebreakers have to arrive in some way. So people say, you know what, I'm going to give it a try. I don't know why, but I just feel like I'm going to give this a try. And that's the miracle. That's the greatest miracle in this world that possibly can happen, is people actually decide, I'm going to give this a try. Game changer. Absolute game changer. Now, in the past, people say, well, I need music, I need flowers, I need a service, I need... No. That's not it. It's to sit quietly for 2 hours. Without all of that pomp and circumstance. Because that's acting out. That's saying, oh, maybe I can act it out this way. Maybe I can act it out this way. Maybe I can act it out with flowers and music and stuff. No. We're not going to act it out. For 2 hours, we're not going to act anything out. Because the good news is so absolutely incredible. My God, I was never born. I never suffered. I never died. All this was a play of light. I'm totally free. I mean, the good news is so staggering. You cannot act it out. You cannot act it out at all, really. And so you have to practice not acting out. Artistically, musically, socially, romantically, thought-wise, dance-wise, movement-wise, acting out, physicality or thought, no, just be non-physical for 2 hours, so to speak. Just let the physical just sit here like a stone for 2 hours. You're not going to act anything out. For 2 hours, you're not going to act anything out. Now, there might be someone talking just to keep you focused on it, you know, it's like, right? There can be someone talking, because sometimes people think that like there's some goal, like the silence. No, it's not so much a goal, the silence, it's just not, you're going to prove to yourself that you can have the capacity to not act out for 2 hours. You can do it. You can do it. And so if there's someone talking about a spiritual topic or whatever, fine. That's not so relevant, actually. To those who are really advanced, it's relevant. But in order to step back from the future of this world, there has to be people from all walks of life to decide, you know what, I can take the plunge, I can do it. For 2 hours, I'm not going to act out anything. We're all just not going to act out anything here at all. Body is just a stone. Senses are a stone. Body is a stone. I'm still potentially functional. No problem. I'm not trying to cripple my potential at all. I'm just trying to prove myself I can not be in the state where where I'm able to not act out anything, which means I can get the great good news, the staggering, unbelievably great news. It's just, you really can hardly believe it. And the news is so great, you can hardly believe it. You can only believe a little of it. You're like, oh. And you just sit there quietly, without acting it out, without gossiping, talking, oh yeah, I got this, I feel it. Did you get this too? No, you just quietly like this and let it impact. It was like a bell is being rung. You just got a little tap of the good news, of the fantastically great news. And when you can prove to yourself, you can do this, you have broken the hold of the spell upon you. You have broken that spell, as it were. At its root, you're starting to dispel all this. And so the fact that you know you can dispel it, you say, well, it may take a while, but I can do it. Then you don't need the future the way that it is. You don't need that. You don't need it. So at least we're talking about this. I've been talking about it for years. And so far, you know, the ice breaking, we're trying, we're leading up to it. Somehow, it needs to happen now. It needs to happen. It needs to happen. And it takes those who really can set their teaching aside, as it were, and say, it doesn't really matter if anyone understands what's said or not. It's just the fact that they try to prove to themselves that they can do this and not act out. We have a culture now that is literally teaching everybody to act out every second of their lives, right? To literally act out every second of their lives. This is the culture that is upon us. And the idea of not doing that doesn't even cross their mind hardly at all. If it does, it'll cross it for a second or two. I've seen that happen. Ah, yeah, that's interesting. I'm not sure how to do that. Oh, boom, off to the next thing. That quick. Click, 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 click culture. The click, click culture. We have the click, click culture. Well, for 2 hours, they're not clicking on anything. People say, well, what good was that for? It's all important because you're proving something to yourself. You're taking a stand and say, you know what? I really am spirit. I'm not this craven coward, really. I'm not this incompetent, stupid, craven slave. Not really. That's not what I really want. I know that's not true. But I have to prove to myself that I can overcome this continuity fear that I have. I have to prove to myself I can do it. Why do you think people in boot camp, they come out and they're transformed, they're so confident? Because they proved to themselves they could do it. Before they didn't think they could, and now they say, hey, I know I can. I can do this. I know I can. I did it. And they're transformed. They're very different now. They say, wow, I'm not the same, you know, coward that I was before. So this is all important. It's all important. And people have to realize that this is what it's about. And for those who are really advanced, they need to help out this too. We're here to help. We're here to help as many as possible back away from that cliff, back away from that edge. Because it's a very bad edge, a very delaying edge that the world is going towards of this hyperactivity. This culture of constant hyperacting out of everything is a very bad edge to go towards, where they can't tolerate the slightest bit of truly great news at all. In fact, they love bad news and, you know, superficial stuff. It's all incredibly superficial to avoid what is self-evident, and you get caught up in this just frantic hyperactivity. Frantic hyperactivity, massive complexity, endless subtlety, endless regulation, endless control. You get caught up in all of that simply because you've never proven to yourself that you can sit quietly for 2 hours and not act anything out. We absolutely have that capacity within us. So those who are advanced in that way, you know, need to help out showing, yeah, look, we can do it. We're doing it. We can do it. We're doing it. It's not that difficult. Reassure others. You can do it. You can do it. The world is not really ready for advanced teachings, to tell you the truth. It's really not. But backing away from this edge will give them the opportunity to go in that direction, for sure. For sure. And once they start going that direction, for the outcome is not in doubt. So we will see. We will see if what occurs along these lines. I don't know. I've been pushing this for a long time. This idea for, oh wow, what's it been? 17 years or so, at least, in most of my life. But for a long time, I've been saying, you know, something has to galvanize people to at least try. Otherwise, you know, they're lost to a major cycle of delay. So something has to galvanize to at least try. I haven't been able to find anything, any way to galvanize anyone really. So we have to do better, We have to do better. The light itself has to take the lead. Let the light take the lead. Let the light take the lead. Surrender to the light and let the light take the lead in this situation. Because only the light reassuring that it is light, only that light that is reassuring light that it is light, that light needs to take the lead, because that light is the icebreaker. That's the icebreaker right there. Okay. So we've got our focus, actually. We've got our focus, and let's see what happens.